overflowing mercy on your family, for whom our Lord Jesus Christ was willing to be betrayed, to be given over to the hands of sinners, and to suffer death on the cross, who now lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. And you may be seated.
First reading comes from Isaiah chapter 52. See, my servant shall prosper. He shall be exalted and lifted up, and shall be very high. Just as there were many who were astonished at him, so marred was his appearance beyond human semblance, and his form beyond that of mortals. So he shall startle many nations. Kings shall shut their mouths because of him. For that which had not been told them, they shall see, and that which they had not heard, they shall contemplate. Who has believed what we have heard? And to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? For he grew up before him like a young plant, and like a root out of dry ground. He had no form or majesty that we should look at him, nothing in his appearance that we should desire him. He was despised and rejected by others, a man of suffering and acquainted with infirmity, and as one from whom others hide their faces. He was despised, and we held him of no account. Surely he has borne our infirmities and carried our diseases, yet we accounted him stricken, struck down by God and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions, crushed for our iniquities. Upon him was punishment that made us whole, and by his bruises we are healed. All we, like sheep, have gone astray. We have all turned to our own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he did not open his mouth. Like a lamb that is led to the slaughter, and like a sheep that before its shearers is silent, so he did not open his mouth. By a perversion of justice he was taken away. Who could have imagined his future? For he was cut off from the land of the living, stricken for the transgression of my people. They made his grave with the wicked and his tomb with the rich. Although he had done no violence and there was no deceit in his mouth, yet it was the will of the Lord to crush him with pain. When you make his life an offering for sin, he shall see his offspring and shall prolong his days. Through him the will of the Lord shall prosper. Out of his anguish he shall see light. He shall find satisfaction through his knowledge. The righteous one, my servant, shall make many righteous, and he shall bear their iniquities. Therefore I will allot him a portion with the great, and he shall divide the spoil with the strong, because he poured out himself to death and was numbered with the transgressors. Yet he bore the sin of men and made intercession for the transgressors. Here ends the first reading. Let us read Psalm 22 responsively. My God, why have you forsaken me? Why so far from saving me? So far from the words of my groaning.
My God, I cry out my day, but you do not answer. By night I find no rest in the rest.
Yet you are the Holy One, enthroned on the praises of Israel.
Our ancestors have put their trust in you, They trusted and you rescued them.
They cried out to you and were delivered. They trusted in you and were not put to shame.
But as me, I am a worm and not a human, scorned by all, despised by the people.
All who see me laugh me to scorn. They curl their lips, they shake their heads.
I trust in the Lord, let the Lord deliver, let God rescue me, the cause is the blessed.
Yet you are the one who drew me forth from the womb and kept me safe on my mother's breast.
I have been entrusted to you ever since I was born. You are my God, and I was still in my mother's womb.
Be not far from me, for trouble is near, and there is no one to help.
Many young bulls encircle me, strong bulls surround me.
They open wide their jaws at me, like a slashing and roaring lion.
I am poured out like water, all my bones are out of joint, my heart within my breast is melting wax.
My strength is dried up like a potsherd. My tongue sticks to the roof of my mouth, and you have laid me in the dust of death.
Paths of death are closed to those men, and their evil doers are terrifying. They pierce my hands and my feet.
I can count all my bones while they stare at me and gloat.
They divide my garments among them. For my clothing they cast lots.
You, O Lord, be not far away. O my help, hasten to my aid.
Deliver me from the sword, my life from the power of trouble.
Save me from the lion's mouth, from the horns of wild bulls. You have rescued me.
I will declare your name to my people, in the midst of the assembly of praise.
You who fear the Lord, give praise. All you of Jacob's line, give glory. Stand in awe of the Lord, all you offspring of Israel.
For the Lord does not despise the poor in their poverty. Neither does the Lord spare his children from them. But when they cry out, the Lord hears them.
From you comes my praise in the great assembly. I will perform my vows in the sight of those who fear the Lord.
The poor shall eat and be satisfied. Let those who seek the Lord give praise. May their hearts live forever.
All the ends of the earth shall remember and turn to the Lord. All the families of nations shall bow before God.
For dominion belongs to the Lord, who rules over the nations.
Indeed, all who sleep in the earth shall bow down and worship. All who go down to the dust, though they be dead, shall kneel before the Lord.
Their descendants shall serve the Lord, who shall bring to generations to come.
They shall proclaim God's deliverance to a people yet unborn, saying to them, the Lord has acted. The second reading is from Hebrews chapter 10, verses 16 to 25. This is the covenant that I will make with them. After those days, says the Lord, I will put my laws in their heart, and I will write them on their minds. He also adds, I will remember their sins and their lawless deeds no more. Where there is forgiveness of these, there is no longer any offering for sin. Therefore, my friends, since we have confidence to enter the sanctuary by the blood of Jesus, by the new and living way that he opened for us through the curtain, that is through his flesh, and since we have a great priest over the house of God, let us approach with a true heart and full assurance of faith, with our hearts sprinkled clean from an evil conscience, and our bodies washed with pure water. Let us hold fast to the confession of our hope without wavering, For he who has promised is faithful. And let us consider how to provoke one another to love and good deeds, not neglecting to meet together, as is the habit of some, but encouraging one another, and all the more as you see the day approaching. Here ends the second reading.
Yes, I was there. I was there throughout the whole ordeal. But then, I was with him all along, right from the very beginning. I was with him in the wilderness. It was I who said, "If you are the Son of God, command that these stones be turned into bread." I was trying to convince him, even then, that he was a fool for believing that he was the promised one, that he could have any effect on humankind and its destiny. But he was too strong for me then. He pushed me aside and began his work, but I am not to be dismissed that easily. I followed him and I attacked him again and again, but I went about it in a different way. I lashed out at him through his followers, those who came to hear his teachings, but again, I failed. For his words warmed even the saddest of hearts. The blind received their sight, the lame walked, the dead returned to life. But I was not to be outdone. I remained with his followers, and some of them I won. Through my efforts, some of them sought ways to trap him, discredit him, and finally destroy him. I even worked my way into a circle of friends. I convinced one of them to betray him. It took a lot of doing, but I had him where I wanted him. Because of me, he said, "Let this cup pass from me." He was wondering if it had to be this way. He was doubting the climax of his mission. Yes, he knew that I was there. He had seen my presence in the faces of his followers, and once again, he was feeling my attempt to surround him. I am doubt, and I was there. I was there, but I failed to destroy him. Once again, he dismissed me with, "Not my will, but yours be done." I was there, but he overcame me.
I'm sorry, and I was there. Believe me, I was there too. I too attacked in vengeance. Many have fallen from broken heart I inflict, not this one. Many have abandoned their goals, their hopes, their dreams, and choose to himself pity. But again, he did not. I did my best to defeat him. I reminded him constantly that he was unwanted in this world. I came to him as rejection, scorn, ridicule. I tried to tell him that he was ridiculous for loving those who did not want him. I did my best, but I too failed. Oh, I brought him plenty of heartache. I caused tears fill his eyes on many occasions, but I could not break him. I could not break him. I could not even make him feel sorry for himself. Even as he struggled on underneath his cross, his thoughts were on others. He said, "Daughters of Jerusalem, weep not for me, but for yourselves and your children." I inflicted myself heavily upon him, but I cannot show him. I was there, but he overcame me.
I am fear, and I was there. I literally surrounded him. I was with him in the garden. It was I who placed those great drops of sweat upon his forehead. I danced at him in the soldiers' flaming torches, and I winked at him in the glistering of their swords and spears. I was present in every crack of the whip, and I was in each descending hammer's blows that drove the nails through his hands and feet. I was quite effective against his disciples. One of them denied ever knowing him, and they all ran like frightened children. I felt certain that I could destroy him. I longed to hear his voice beg for mercy. I longed to hear him promise to leave the country and abandon his foolish mission. I longed to hear this, but he remained silent. He refused to defend himself. He refused to retract anything that he had said. To be sure, he felt my presence, but I couldn't destroy him. I had failed. I was there, but he overcame me.
am shame. I was there, perhaps I failed, because he was so used to me by now. I had been with him since his birth, after all. I was a manger, the king's cradle. I was beside him in Nazareth with his friends and neighbors, ran him out of town as a false prophet. I was in the searing faces of his tormentors. I was the crown of thorns around his clothing. I was in the sun that hang over his head. I was the cross itself, making it heavier as he carried. I was there, but I could not break his spirit. I was there, but he overcame me.
I was there, and I didn't let him forget my presence for 1 minute. I burned into his forehead with the thorns. I caused the sweat to trickle into his lash marks. I caused him to fall with weariness under the burden of his cross. Then I attacked him as brutally as I could. I ran across his body as the nails pierced his flesh. I caused his tongue to swell and burn with thirst. I beat upon him with the hot rays of the sun, causing his body to dehydrate. As I was increasing my attack to its strongest, I leaped for joy, for I thought I had succeeded. I heard him cry, my God, why? But my celebration was premature, for with his final words, he entrusted himself into his Father's hands. I am agony, and I afflicted him greatly, but I too failed to destroy him. I was there, but he overcame me. I was there, and how I hated him. But you see, I hate everybody, for I hate. I do my job well, and I intended to destroy this teacher of love. And I tried. Believe me, I tried. But what were the results? He said, Father, forgive. I couldn't even make him hate that miserable wretch hanging beside him who asked for mercy. He wouldn't curse his tormentors. He wouldn't curse his fathers, and worst of all, he would even curse himself. For going through with this foolish endeavor, oh, how I hated him. But I couldn't make him hate me. He's my greatest failure. I hate was there, but he overcame me.
Thank you. I was there, and unlike all the others, I did not fail. Sooner or later, everyone falls beneath my power, and it turns out that this man is no different from the rest. Oh yeah, he made a lot of grand promises. He called himself the resurrection and the life. But today, I prove that even he must submit to my eternal darkness. I proved that the peace, joy, and love that he spoke of will melt away in my presence. Tonight, I reign victorious, and he lies defeated. He lies still like a defeated army at the end of a war. The war is over, and I have won. I am death. Yes, I was there, and the victory is mine. He did not overcome me.
As is traditional for many centuries, this evening we join in the bidding prayer. Let us pray, brothers and sisters, for the Holy Church throughout the world. Almighty and eternal God, you have shown your glory to all nations in Jesus Christ. By your Holy Spirit, guide the Church and gather it throughout the world. Help it to persevere in faith, proclaim your name, and bring the good news of salvation in Christ to all people. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray next for Elizabeth, James, Israel, Peter, Tom, and for all servants of the Church and for all people of God. Almighty and eternal God, your Spirit guides the Church and makes it holy. Strengthen and uphold our bishops, pastors, other ministers, and lay leaders. Keep them in health and safety for the good of the Church. And help each of us in our various vocations to do faithfully the work to which you have called us. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Let us pray next for those preparing for baptism. Almighty and eternal God, you continue to bless the Church. Increase the faith and understanding of those preparing for baptism. Give them new birth as your children, and keep them in the faith and communion of your Holy Church. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us now pray for our sisters and brothers who share our faith in Jesus Christ. Eternal God, you give your Church unity. Look with favor on all who follow Jesus, your Son. Make all the baptized one in the fullness of faith, and keep us united in the fellowship of love. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Let us pray for the Jewish people, the first to hear the word of God. Almighty and eternal God, long ago you gave your promise to Abraham and your teaching to Moses. Hear our prayers that the people you called and elected as your own may receive the fulfillment of the covenant's promises. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray next for those who do not share our faith in Jesus Christ. Almighty and eternal God, gather into your embrace all those who call out to you under different names. Bring an end to interreligious strife and make us more faithful witnesses of the love made known to us in your Son. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray for those who do not believe in God. Almighty and eternal God, you created humanity so that all may long to know you and find peace in you. Grant that all may recognize the signs of your love and grace in the world and in the lives of Christians, and gladly acknowledge you as the one true God. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray next for God's good creation. Almighty and eternal God, you are the creator of a magnificent universe. Hold all the worlds in the arms of your care and bring all things to fulfillment in you. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray for those who serve in public office. Almighty and eternal God, you are the champion of the poor and oppressed. In your goodness, give wisdom to those in authority, so that all people may enjoy justice, peace, freedom, and a share in the goodness of your creation. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray for those who are in particular need. Almighty and eternal God, you give strength to the weary and new courage to those who have lost heart. Heal the sick, comfort the dying, give safety to travelers, free those unjustly deprived of liberty, and deliver your world from falsehood, hunger, and disease. Hear the prayers of all who call on you in any trouble, that they may have the joy of receiving your help in their need. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. And finally, let us pray for all those things for which our Lord Jesus would have us ask. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Would you please stand for the concluding final verse and hymn? We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you. By your holy cross, you have redeemed the world.